In this video, I'm going to show you a quick and simple dodge and bend technique that will give you amazing results. Okay, let's do this. So I'm going to go down on this circle and then I'm going to click on curves here. I'm going to make a point in the middle of the curve and then I'll push it up like this. So I'm going to close this and then I'm going to double click on the curve here. So I'm going to name this curve as light. I'm going to go back on this circle. Then I'm going to select curves here. So I'm going to make a point in the middle of the curve and then I'll push it down like this. I'm going to close this. I'm going to double click on the curve. I'm going to name this as dark, like this. So with these adjustments, when I go on image and then if I try to select the apply image here, I can't select the apply image because it's grayed out. So what you need to do when you experience something like this, just go on the adjustment layer here and then select the layer mask here. Now go to image and then apply image is now active. So I'm going to select apply image here. So this box is going to pop up. Let me just put it here. So on the source here, I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Layer, I'm just going to leave it on merged. Channel, I'm going to leave it on RGB. So blending here, I'm going to leave it at multiply. Opacity, 100%. This box, I'm not going to tick it. This box, I'm not going to tick it. And then I'm just going to click on OK here. On the light here, I'm going to select this layer mask. And then I'm going to go to image and then apply image. Source, I'm going to leave it the way it is. Layer, merged. Channel, I'm going to leave it at RGB. Blending, I'm going to leave it at multiply. Opacity, I'm going to leave it at 100%. This box, I'm not going to tick it. This box, I'm not going to tick it. Then I'm just going to click on OK here. So I'm going to select this layer mask here. I'm going to hold Ctrl plus I on the keyboard to invert the layer mask. So this is our before. This is our after. This is our before. This is our after. So I'm going to select the dark adjustment here. And then I'm going to reduce the opacity of this to maybe 60%. And then I'm going to select the light adjustment layer here. I'm going to reduce the opacity to maybe 60% as well. So this is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. So this is the easiest way you can do the dodging and burning. So now let me show you the quickest way you can do the dodging and burning using an action. So let's move to this image. So I'm going to go on this action button here. If you can't find this action button, just go to window and select actions here. The action panel is going to pop up. I'm going to go to my beauty retouching actions pack. Then I'm going to select the auto dodge and burn like this. So this action is going to do everything that I showed you in the previous example. Let me just close this. The action did everything for me. The only thing that I'm going to do from here is to paint where I want to dodge and burn like this. I'm going to do the same here like this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If the effect is too much, I can just reduce the opacity here to maybe 40%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So let me go to my actions here. So this action, the auto dodge and burn, it's in my beauty retouching actions pack. I'll put the links where you can download my beauty retouching actions pack in the video description below. So let's move to this example here. I'm going to go to my actions and then I'm going to select the auto dodge and burn. I'm going to click on it like this. I'm going to close my actions here. So the action will do everything for me. So the only thing that I'm going to do from here is just to paint where I want to dodge and burn. Like this. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. So if the effect is too much, I can just reduce the opacity here to maybe 35%. This is the before. This is the after. If I want more of this effect, I can just drag my opacity to maybe 70%. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is the after. I'm going to balance it. I'm going to leave it at maybe 50%. This is the before. This is the after. This is the before. This is our after. If you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my beauty retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. And if you want to learn the best way to color grade your photos, you should check this video on top. And if you want to learn how to apply makeup in Photoshop, you should check this video down here.